that theater, great theater, is made through collaborative cooperation and collective effort. That was our belief, and it remains our belief. And that's what binds us. We have incredibly, incredibly varying aesthetics, incredibly varying missions amongst our companies. But this is what we share. And it's powerful, it's vital. We prove over and over again that we are a force for good in this world. Yes. I would like to have all current and former board members of the Network of Ensemble Theaters please rise. Yay! Greg Tate. Being here in this space reminds me of Greg because he came to these gatherings and he was such a great presence. One of the members of the Heartbeat Ensemble. Great performer, great spirit. Greg Tate. We remember you. Okay, upstart.
Walker and Kate Quinn. Conrad Bishop and Elizabeth Fuller.
Thank you.
There.
Yes, yes.
Ruth Balachick and Judith Malia.
Yes.
Reza Abdo.
Yeah. Right.
Joe Carson. Participatory in just a moment, but
if you like something I say, you can make noises. But also, if you don't like something I say, you can interrupt me. Please do. You know, I can't represent the full diversity of our field. That can't be on me or any one of us. So if I say something that feels wrong, please stand up and gently correct me. I embrace gentle corrections. just make them brief because I don't have a lot of time. I want to, you know, just again acknowledge the resilience and longevity of the field. We are approaching a big anniversary, which is exciting, but also what's so thrilling is how many people for whom this is their first net gathering. And I want to acknowledge that as the field has grown, it's changed. There's just a lot more practitioners identifying as ensemble, and that's really thrilling. The growth is actually kind of amazing. There are numbers about it, and we could have Ella come out here and do a statistical presentation. We also know that ensemble's profile has lifted, not anywhere near as big as it should be, but it is not insignificant. The amount of change that has occurred in regional theaters recognizing the value of the work of ensembles, of funders recognizing the work of ensembles, and thank you to the funders who have made the time to come here and be with us. All are awesome. So much to that. And since that's been around, there's been a lot of changes in the broader culture. You know, there's a lot of conversation around how data and measurement and impact drive how we talk about the work we do, and that's good and it's bad, right? It's mixed, it's both. It's the rise of our digital age, so we can say hi to HowlRound. And what that means for live arts, right? It's not good or bad, it's both. The rise of participation, right? Last night was a really good example of that. Participation is much bigger, and not just in a theatrical sense. Our expectations of participation culturally, as a democracy, are rising. Inquiry of place, perhaps in reaction to the digital age, the arts have become a lot more invested in place, and that is a fraught conversation, right? Even the term place-making has a lot of ambivalence, right? But it's real. It's a big change that has occurred and is continuing to occur in our field. Political polarization. We exist in an age right now where a mainstream candidate can rise to prominence by suggesting we deport 11 million people. That
no,
is...
guacamole for immigrant haters.
Sorry. Guacamole for immigrant haters. That is a beautiful interruption.
I'm sorry, that's
for real,
a
right?
Come
that, I'm not sure how possible that could have been. That is, this is showing this rise in political polarization, but at the same time, there's a renewed commitment to social justice. And movements that are identify as social justice are operating in an intersectional way, right? It's the recognition that racial justice is climate justice, is economic justice, and so on. And, you know, so that gives me hope that maybe what is happening in our country is, you know, that moment in an ensemble where you kind of go along to get along. And then you reach that point, right, where you got to actually be clear on what you're talking about and what you mean and what you're really trying to do. So my hope is that that's what's happening in the U.S., right? That, like, this incredible polarization where everyone's just yelling at each other. It's like that moment in the ensemble room. You're like, no, what I mean is this. But that on the other end of that is a much healthier United States and country. And that journey that we have been on culturally has really been reflected in what that has been doing. Who here have attended at least one microfest? If your hand is not raised now, do not feel bad. It is merely an opportunity for you to make a new relationship and to talk to someone who had their hand raised. A lot of the phenomenal work that happened during the microfests was really in conversation with those things that I just talked about, right? And through those microfests, we know a lot more than we know now. These are some things that I think we know, and from the board perspective, a lot of what we've been doing, honestly, has just been unpacking all the things that we discovered from the microfest and trying to understand what they mean for NET moving forward. And I didn't get to finish this list in my little morning thing, so bear with me as I improvise the rest of it. The first piece is that we really need to resist that polarization. There has been a conversation within this community that has positioned work that defines itself as primarily about artistic inquiry, and work that defines itself as social justice is somehow being opposite or a binary. I think what we have learned is that they are on a spectrum. They inform and support each other. Work that is in community or doing social justice very often has to be incredibly innovative in its artistic inquiry in order to achieve the goal that it's trying to do. And very often, the work that comes out of the artistic inquiry is the tool we've been looking for to make the change that we want to see, right? So these things are in conversation with each other, and we are stronger for those differences. The second piece is the work must be diverse and equitable, or it must not be. We are not going to go back to a time where there is just one kind of voice that is representing what net is, what the field is. That just can't be anymore, right? We acknowledge that we got two co-chairs that are white coming up here, right? Part of not going back is acknowledging things like that. So I want, over the course of this time, for us to be really brave in interrupting power dynamics that are problematic. We make each other stronger when we do that. We do not get defensive when that happens. We thank people for that, right? Okay, this is the part where I get to improvise. I ran out of time. I think the third piece, because we really want to get to actually talking to each other and not just listening to board chairs talk, is that it is going to be participatory. The future of NET is going to be co-created. That is the roots of NET. The network of ensemble theaters was just that in its beginning. It was a network of ensemble theaters figuring out what they wanted to do together. I am one of the inheritors of that extraordinary legacy. And as we stand at this particular moment of transition, which is not just about a staff transition, but I think something much larger in our field and in our culture, where the world is looking for different models of being together, different models of distributing power and access and decision making, we have a unique moment to think about how NET can co-create that future. So a lot of what we're going to be doing together in this time is thinking about what collaborative creation means, not just in its traditional confines of ensemble practice, but perhaps more broadly across discipline, across sector. And we are going to be co-creating together the future of what NET looks like. So what that means is you are all tasked with a responsibility. You are all tasked with a responsibility for what NET looks like. It is not enough to sit back unless you are sitting back and listening with incredible intention. That is all I have to say.
We've got a lot of new people with us and a lot of not new people with us, but I really want to get a sense and have all of us get a sense of who's in the room and also give you some time. I know there's been a lot of conversations happening so far, but give you some time to talk amongst yourselves a little bit before we all scatter away. So I'm gonna move this so nobody gets hurt first, but can we do a little cultural mapping for a minute? Can I?
Yes.
As you are able and willing to stand, and let's go with how old is your ensemble or the organization that you identify as being most closely affiliated with, whichever of those applies to you. I'm going to say from you started this morning to you've been around for since the dawn of time, kind of stretch around and go that way. So really new to really old. And you can talk.
Can you say a couple more times?
How old is your ensemble or the organization that you affiliate or
thank you. That's me.
One year. And what's the name of your?
Native Voices.
Native Voices, 1 year. And you guys down here, who's on our tail end? how old? Number of years?
Since 1971, till our day.
Yeah.
Awesome. So can you kind of give me a sense of what you're?
Older.
Yeah, Justin Memorial Church, 1860.
Five, seven. is really close to where you are in this line.
Find yourself somebody else, and you got a minute.
to think about one word that you want to keep with you during your time here and be thinking about. And that can be something that you heard or you said in some of this, or something new. Thank you. Shireen is going to talk to us a little about the open space stuff that's about to happen. Great, come on.
Hi. Okay. So, those of you who are going to the zoo field trip, just meet outside of the lodge to organize yourselves. Those of you who are going to the new to net open space, we're just going to stay here. Those of you who are interested in international collaboration with Marcella, you guys are going to go to the library with Nick. Marcella, will you raise your hand? Are you in here? Marcella, Nick, will you guys connect about any, like, if you need extra chairs or anything? Nick's your man. He'll get you set up. Everybody, Nick and Amanda have been supporting and doing an amazing thing. Cultural change consultancy, blah 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 blah. Will you go with Amanda Morgan? You guys talked already, and they're going to lead you to arts and crafts. Any questions else about open space? If you want to organize a different open space, meet outside the lodge and see who you can grab.
Can you tell us again, based on the rest of the schedule, when you would ideally like these to wrap up?
11:45 is when they should wrap up. You have a break at 11:15. And then we meet back here for the next plenary. That happens now. Yes. Any questions? All right. Have fun at your open space.
Thank